picking through tons of trash each day, sorting out recyclables. For the many Christians living in Cairo's garbage slums, it's the only life they know. One ministry's amazing work here is featured in a new book by Johns Hopkins Hospital surgeon Marty McCary, called Mama Maggie.
Many of them had a lot of discrimination and persecution in the rural areas. And when they've migrated into the city, there was no place really to live except in the trash for many of them that were poor, mostly driven by the bad economy, but in part by the discrimination for jobs. They decided to sift through the trash. It's the most efficient recycling operation in the world.
And those who visit these Cairo neighborhoods will see garbage everywhere, in the streets, and even piled inside the homes of the Zebulun, the garbage people. Many children here do not attend school. They spend their days picking through the garbage to help their families earn a few dollars per day. It's a hopeless existence, but one Christian's goal is to give them love today and a future tomorrow. Mama Maggie, as she is known, hopes to give them a chance at life. She wasn't there the day CBN News visited Cairo, but we witnessed firsthand the lasting impact Mama Maggie's ministry is having on the kids of the garbage slums.
Unlike Mother Teresa, who essentially came from poverty and took a vow for poverty, Mama Maggie came from wealth. And during an encounter when she was a successful marketing executive, connected with a child in the garbage slums, a famous district of Cairo that's been mostly neglected.
She found joy and happiness there and returned over time. She eventually gave up her marketing career and started a ministry called Stephen's Children. Today, 500 full-time staff members and hundreds of volunteers serve more than 30,000 children every day. The kids forego some of their garbage picking for several hours of fun and education.
Now, Mama Maggie's ministry has more than 90 of these community centers throughout Egypt. And children like these come here not only to learn reading and writing and arithmetic and also values, but how to dream big.
Well, many times when the kids are asked, what do you want to do when you grow up? They've never really thought that far in advance. And some of the kids, can you believe, have never been called by their name by anyone. But no one's ever valued them and asked them that question.
One girl said she only dreamed of having a piece of tomato to eat. Another child said his dream came true at a Stephen's Children camp, where he actually slept in a bed. But dreaming big means learning a skill. Mama Maggie's ministry teaches the children a trade, like shoe and clothing manufacturing, marketable skills for earning money and serving others, whether in the garbage slums or elsewhere.
They're not talking about getting out of the garbage district. They're talking about serving the garbage district. And sure enough, a good number of the full-time staff were kids in the ministry themselves, have graduated and want to give back. I've met doctors that work in the clinics over there, and they're working for almost no money.
Seven of the 21 Egyptian Christians killed by ISIS in Libya last February were helped by Mama Maggie's ministry.
They were kids that she fed and taught and were part of the group. And two of them had become leaders in the ministry. And they're now using that story to teach forgiveness in the Middle East. They're teaching the kids to break the cycle of revenge.
What impresses you the most about Mama Maggie?
Well, I think it's the humility. It is amazing to see that sort of genuine selflessness in a world where you so rarely see it. You know, Gary, when I came back, the thought of being upset at the cab driver or frustrated with the bank ATM or something like that, it just put everything in life in perspective.
A perspective of serving and helping, bringing hope and dignity to the most neglected places. Gary Lane, CBN News, Cairo, Egypt.